Go ahead.
It's always good if you don't fall out of the bus. Like Ford, Gerald Ford, remember?
Down below. Pull the hell.
Hello, how are you? Hi.
Mr. Trump, how
are you? Nice seeing you. Terrific.
Nice to meet you.
Terrific. You know Billy Bush?
Hello, nice to see you. How are you doing, Ariane?
I'm doing very well, thank you. Are you ready to be a soap star?
We're ready. Let's go. Make me a soap star.
How about a little hug for the Donnelly? Just got off the bus.
Would you like a little hug,
darling? Okay, absolutely. Melania said this was okay.
So that, Jim Acosta, you've been covering him from the very beginning. Will this kill his campaign?
I think this could be it. I mean, I think this is one of those moments that come in a campaign, and I think this far exceeds what happened with Mitt Romney's 47% moment. This is one of those moments that just absolutely can sink a campaign. And as Dana was saying earlier, Donald Trump has had a problem with women voters throughout this process. If you're a female voter in Pennsylvania or Ohio and you're sitting on the fence and you're undecided and you're thinking, you know, maybe you don't like Hillary Clinton, so maybe you'll vote for Donald Trump, this is just one of those moments that is just going to give somebody a tremendous amount of pause. And for this to happen 2 days before this rematch debate with Hillary Clinton, this was supposed to be Donald Trump's moment to redeem himself. She has used the term basket of deplorables. There isn't much that is more deplorable than this. I mean, this is the definition of deplorable. He is in his own basket of deplorables right now.
He did say, though, that compared to what he heard Bill Clinton say on the golf course, this was modest. You heard him in that statement he released when he sort of apologized.
Okay, I mean, look, he might be right about that, but it doesn't matter. Bill Clinton's already been president. He's not running for president now. And
we don't have a tape of him on the golf course.
And we don't have a tape, and we're not hearing it, and voters aren't hearing it, and it's not Hillary Clinton. He's running against Hillary Clinton, not Bill Clinton. And that's a big difference that, you know, everybody needs to keep in mind right now.
And keep in mind, go ahead, Brianna.
Sorry, David.
I was just going to say, to that point, as our colleague Anderson Cooper said to Donald Trump, you know, quite frankly, that sounds like the excuse of a five-year-old as well.
And you look at the apology, I mean, a couple of points here. So you said sort of apologize, which is, that's very accurate, because he attributes it to locker room banter. I mean, the proper apology.
Let me read the statement that he released. He said this, and we can put it up on the screen. Quote, "This was locker room banter, a private conversation that took place many years ago. Bill Clinton has said far worse to me on the golf course, not even close. I apologize if anyone was offended."
So a couple points. He tries to dismiss it as locker room banter, which is not an effective way to apologize. And then he tries to push it away to somebody else, which is sort of typical Donald Trump. But in a normal apology, that would not be appropriate. And then the way he ends it with, "I apologize if anyone was offended," the lack of awareness there. If anyone was offended, I mean, certainly people are going to be offended by this. And when you say, and I think we all know this, because I'm sure, I hope all of us have apologized to someone in our lives, when you say, "Well, I'm sorry if I offended you," it diminishes the effectiveness of your apology. But just talking strategy here, the Clinton campaign strategy when it comes to Donald Trump is to hold him to where he is, which is about it nationally 40%. You look at these battleground states, that's really what's more important. But hold him where he is, because they know that once people go to Donald Trump, this is what they say, they're not coming back. So hold him. I mean, he's basically holding himself by doing something like this. It's going to be a struggle. He needs, at this point in time where he's the one on the ropes, he needs to be able to get every last vote that he can in these battleground states. And this gets in his way of doing that. Just talking strategy, not about how offensive what he said was.
And